Good evening and welcome to Exact Tech Arena at the Stephen C. O'Connell Center in Gainesville, Florida, on the campus of the University of Florida. Tonight, a Sunshine State showdown for a trip to the Sweet 16, featuring two ranked teams in NCAA Division I Women's Volleyball Championship action as 24th ranked Miami takes on the 16th seed, 21st ranked Florida Gators. This is what's going on in Gainesville. As the Florida Gators, Mary Wise earning her 1,000th career win last night in the sweep over Florida A&M. But she says, just looking for the next win. And this one is the most important one as Florida looks to make it to a regional semifinal. For Miami, Jose Keno Gundara, in his ninth season at Miami, also looking for that trip to the Sweet 16. As the tournament field dwindles, it's win or move on. And these two teams here in the state of Florida doing battle tonight for a trip to the next round. Tom Collette with you tonight. We have Scott Snyder and our crew giving you all the great pictures. Glad you're along for the ride. Miami will play in the court to our left, wearing their all black uniforms tonight, and the Florida Gators in the court to your right in the white tops with the blue shorts. Florida starts Victoria, Forte, Beeson, Montserrat, Thayer Hall, and Ellie McKissick. Miami will serve to open up the match. It will be Savannah Bach doing the orders. The honors, excuse me, as McKissick will make the opening pass for Florida, and they run the offense to the outside. The left-handed tip across from Thayer Hall. Right and to the right side goes Miami to Yardimchi, but there's the big Florida block right up with Thayer Hall and Lauren Forte blocking it back, and the Gators break out on top. Miami started with Vach, Kale Nuvalu, Grieve, Leao, dressed in orange, Yardimchi, right number 23, and Tonta. Receiving the serve, and the setter there, Vach, makes the play to the right side, and the ball is down. Beeson with the attempt on the dig, but we're tied at one.
Merritt Beeson, but just sliding in front of her, that ball now tying it up at 1-1. With the kill there is
Angela
Miami.
Grieve serving for the Hurricanes here.
Smart change
is that last
Miami
kill for Angela Grieve for the Hurricanes.
Grieve will send it over to Thayer Hall. Now
Montserrat sets one to the outside to Victoria, and Victoria with the kill. Sophia Victoria, the sophomore from Carabo, Puerto Rico, had a team-high 13 kills in the win last night against Florida A&M. Pressed into the starting lineup after Tiara Caesar, senior, all-SEC performer, left the team for mental health reasons to take care of herself, and the team supports her in that move.
Here is Trinity Adams coming up,
giving her love and support. And she sends it back to the team as they move on in the NCAA tournament last night. And a quick middle set to Bree Kelly. SEC all-freshman team selection.
And then in this case,
it's 3-1 Florida.
Yardimchi at the right side. She's 6 foot tall, but just those couple of inches of
Kelly
difference.
Can also get it out to the right antenna on that slide play that the Gators like to run, one of their trademarks for a number of years. To the right side goes Miami. Yardimchi is dug up by Thayer Hall. Marley tried the second contact dump, did Montserrat. Free ball sent across by the Hurricanes. Bree Kelly tried to flick the wrist and push one across, but into the net.
Was a little bit farther back off the net than she expected.
The attack error for Bree Kelly.
And that's one of those just kind of freshman errors.
She and Merritt Beeson on the all-freshman team in the Southeastern Conference.
She's receiving the quick Gators set off the net. I'm going to say that those are one of the metrics that are important to pay attention to.
Third place in the SEC at 14-4. Miami 25-4, 15-3. They finished third in the ACC behind Louisville, the number one overall seed in this tournament this year. And Pitt, as it looks like Savannah Bach doing some work on her right shoe, the laces.
A little bit of a break in play here.
We shorten up those laces just a bit.
Looked like at first she was
these two teams have met on two previous occasions.
Then assistant coach and a trainer was over there.
Both have been in the NCAA tournament, and Gators won both of the meetings. Last time in the Gators' run to the NCAA championship match in 2017 here in Gainesville.
First set up,
Victoria with the swing and the kill. About two steps inside that left antenna, not all the way out to the antenna.
Good for kill number two. 4-2, the score.
And gave her plenty of space to go to her left around the block. Set up on the right side there by Payman Yardimchi.
Miami. Looks like we have a challenge here.
And I believe we have our first challenge of the evening.
To point out that that Miami hasn't always had.
We'll wait for the public address announcer Jeff Cardozo to make the announcement.
When it comes to playing teams with McKissick's.
Yeah,
I see the quizzical look on your face. Ellie McKissick's older sister Maddie
challenging
is the setter
that the ball stayed
Tech.
In.
Oh wow!
And Wade like Brent's I said, that's running the match loss. Tonight as the up official, the R1
been
and
a good
Darren
bit of time
Clark
winning since
over
then.
There
on a streak.
With.
Ooh, that's a tough call, and we see it up at the video board. It looks
official,
like to me it hit.
Gosh, a great look from our crew.
Looks
it looked
like
it might have caught some orange.
Just barely.
In volleyball, the sideline,
right,
that orange line
whether that
is
angle
in.
Attack was inbounds or out. That's what.
And here's another look
from
at it. Oh, that
now
one.
This angle looks like it's out.
The ball compresses. Did it catch all blue,
really,
or did it
you,
catch
it
a little
like
bit
that
of orange?
Oh, yeah.
The first look
no,
I took a look at
before
it looked like
if
it was
anything, it's
catching
just
some
by the
orange. That one is very close.
That ball is
early challenge called
for. What'll be interesting to see,
by
you know, we've
Jose
talked before on air about the progression of this replay and how
as again for Florida
changed,
and Miami.
The experimental rule.
It'll either be
4-2
Florida or 3-3 if Miami's challenge holds up for the head coach.
More funding and more technology.
UC Santa Barbara grad of 1990.
To get it on par with sports like
the
tennis.
Unique
because right now.
Fact about him, he represented both the USA and Puerto Rico in international competition on their respective national teams.
But right now
teams.
You're at the whim of
ninth
the
year
technology, the camera angles that you have.
Miami coaching the Hurricanes. Challenge denied.
To be conclusive evidence.
Score remains 4-2 Florida.
Official, the replay official to overturn the replay.
So 4-2 Florida.
Marley Montserrat set,
set
to serve.
Number one back to serve will be Marley Montserrat.
The Gators.
Montserrat sends it over.
Tough serve. Handled.
One is picked up by Michelina Rolla.
Gators block it back, but the ball is played
back
up.
Reset. First to Victoria. Now back to
right side. Beeson for Florida.
Comes off
nice
the
up from Hernandez.
Set up left side and blocked back again.
Kelly goes one on one with
Leao.
Right side. Yardimchi.
And that one's picked up off the swing from Yardimchi.
Ball in the air. A long time. Victoria hits it off the block for the kill.
Left side again. Her third
Yardimchi
kill.
And Leao were there for Miami, but didn't penetrate the plane to the net all the way.
Point out a couple people have messaged in.
Sophia Victoria off to a good start. 3-for-3 as the Gators take a 3-point lead at 5-2.
Over on TV. I just want to let you know that our broadcast studio is working on that. We'll get it sorted
Gators
out.
Gators served
you
it well last night against Florida A&M with
here's
12 Marley service Martin aces, a record in rally scoring era in NCAA tournament.
Unsuccessful.
That'll be four hits on Florida.
Over. Last person to touch it was Janice Leao. Leao has it bobbled
as for Miami,
three Gators and then
they took out
the
South Alabama after dropping the first set. A set which they were up 23-20, roared back to take the match.
Sends it over to McKissick. Now for Montserrat.
As Florida will go
Main
back
Street,
row, just a roll shot for Thayer
Hall.
Picked
up by Miami.
Played up by Rosado.
Right side attack error that time from
Janice
Leao.
Leao hits the ball in the net
three,
there.
Florida, as she hit
Leao,
into the
one of two Miami Hurricanes
action
to play in every
at
set
Leao,
this
Leao,
season.
Rather, at 6-3,
came into the weekend 10th in the NCAA with almost 1.4 blocks per set.
Just a miscalculation there. Trying to get
she
around
had
the
five
block
block assists and two block solos last night against South Alabama. Florida back
serve
with the serve with Victoria.
Looks so clean.
Picked up by Rosado. And now
great up from Montserrat with one hand.
One is actually sent back for Florida. Set by
Hall
Montserrat
from the left side
over
with the tip.
Thayer Hall. Joust at the net is going to be won by Florida. Left side swing, and this one's just tipped over by
Rolla. Montserrat will set it out to Thayer
Hall,
who hits it off hands at the block. And trying to make a play behind the block was Yardimchi for Miami, but couldn't come up with it.
How about Marley Montserrat with the one-arm dig to keep that alive to begin with?
Florida pushes out to an early 4-point lead over the in-state rival Miami.
Scramble for the play and still coming up with a three.
On the line for these two teams, a trip to the regional semifinal.
Back to serve now will be Victoria
and the Sweet 16 in this tournament.
That's a service.
That serve.
I may have jinxed
talking about
how clean
Sophia Victoria
makes it look so easy.
Honestly, she does, though. You know, and the mechanics
Florida
of her
last
arm
night, I mentioned those 12 service aces, only two errors on the evening.
Just
a win over Florida A&M.
And if you're not a volleyball player,
as for Miami,
or,
here's Emily,
you know,
Damon
accustomed to listening,
to serve it.
Think about a golf swing and just how it's about the efficiency.
See if they target
mechanics.
Victoria, who
that
is
her swing.
Now in the primary serve
this
receive line, and a quick set to Thayer Hall, and a different look for the veteran outside
kill
hitter Thayer Hall.
Thayer Hall makes it 8-4 Florida.
Drifting to her right just a bit towards
Marley
the middle
Montserrat
of the court.
Doing the same thing with her
and it's down for the kill.
As Bach is doing with her middles. She brings Hall inside the net, halfway between.
That'll bring to the service line Ellie McKissick
hitting against two blocks.
McKissick on the air with 31 service aces, second on the Florida squad. As Miami goes to the outside to
over to McKissick, and this one sent off the net but kept alive by McKissick.
Hall again,
left side fourth there. Hall that
one from
Hernandez. Hernandez.
Greve with the tip
again. Tip it over the block.
Behind the block
first picked up by Monterey. Now set up left side or right side, I should say, for Merritt.
Great up again from Hernandez, the libero.
Rolled
tip
over
shot
the
for
block,
layout.
Picked up by McKissick.
Where will Monterey go? Right
set,
side, back
right
set.
Right side for Merritt.
Nice Beeson up by Rosado from Miami.
By Damon. Up
who will win this long
McKissick
rally as Monterey will go all the way across the court to Hall. And Hall got it for the kill.
The end line for a kill. Might
there,
have been a
Hall
touch.
Off to a wonderful start. 3-0-7, her stat line.
And as Beeson is bombing away from the right side. Great contact
last
from
night,
Hernandez
11
and
kills
Damon
and hit 556, second highest mark
over at that right
on the
side,
season.
Marley Monterey
also had 9 digs, just one short of a double-double.
Coast to coast.
Has scored with a 5-point lead.
To Hall, who puts it away. So impressive the control
with
and
McKissick.
These scrambling, scrappy defensive plays by the Gators.
Everyone goes silent here in the Exact Tech Arena.
McKissick feeds it over to Damon.
Greve off the net.
Now this one blocked back and comes
great
off a
great block
shoot,
cover for Miami.
Greve will fire
Greve and Sophia Victoria can't handle it. The bullet from the
Victoria
left pin.
Good for a kill. Just a
for
weird
Angela Greve. We had a match high 19 kills
and
hit 300.
Actually, I think that was Hernandez's left arm.
Last night.
To cover her own
actually, yesterday afternoon
attack.
Early.
The hardest skill
over South Alabama.
In volleyball because you saw it happen so fast, it's hard to tell what happens.
Yeah, I thought it was somebody's shoe.
Yeah, it's blocked by Florida, but
second team All-ACC on the year, and she misses it wide.
And that serve will go wide left. For the service error, first
Florida
one
10,
of the
Miami
day
5
for Miami.
As the first service error of the evening for Miami, Florida already has one.
Will be Merritt Beeson.
And Merritt Beeson, who has struggled in the earlier part of the year, finding
Beeson
the serve she wants to use in the group,
over,
but no struggle there. The service ace
right and then out of play off of first
service
contact,
ace for Merritt Beeson, who had 3
first service error of the
last
day
night
and
against
I have to
Florida
admit, I was
A&M
down to kind of take care of some of the technical stuff. Did Merritt Beeson
and a timeout early
time
called here
no, I think
by Jose Keno Gandara, head coach of Miami, finding his team, looking up at Florida on the scoreboard, trailing by 6.
We'll take a quick break.
Net connection is required. Home Life Security Services subject to Home Life Security Service Agreement. Cox Home Life Services provided
Florida
by Cox
Gators
license
16th
Cox.
Seed in this
licenses.
NCAA Division I Women's
Florida
Volleyball
Gator
Championship
Volleyball
Tournament off to a hot
ESPN
start tonight against in-state rival Miami.
WRUF.
Currently at 353. 7 kills,
on
only one
network,
error, and 17 swings.
Second round of the
meanwhile,
NCAA tournament between
they've held
Florida
Miami to only a 53
Miami,
hitting efficiency mark.
In the nation versus
Miami only with 3 kills and 2 errors.
Will be Merritt
as again
Beeson.
After the Miami called
Beeson
timeout. Here's the
we'll
serve for Beeson.
Serve over and we'll find
out to the outside
Tontai
to Greve and the
swing
shot is wide.
Will go too far
Merritt
right
Beeson
for Greve.
We'll serve it again
the
for the Gators.
Side. She was trying to work
Florida
the angle.
Seven.
Josh, you were just in the huddle. What did
here
you
in the early
as
going?
The Gators lead 12-5.
That's exactly the focus of the huddle is the net play. I'll finish this thought after this play, but Gators focusing on both sides of the ball at the net.
Here's Beeson.
That's a bullet, and it's
that
just
one
long.
Will go just a smidge too long down
not
the
by
line,
much.
Right side.
Got to make those passers make a decision.
12-6, Florida.
When you serve
and
those
what we discussed again
balls
at the beginning of the match was echoed in that huddle.
From
working
serve
the ball around. Florida
and here is Savannah Vaught.
Monterey to spread the ball
ACC
out
first team.
Guessing.
And she serves it in
the service error this time from Savannah Vaught makes it 13-6.
Second service error of the night for
and then on the
Hurricanes
side of the block.
Florida's lead is once again 7.
Talking about how the quality
to mention the two teams
gotten with the block have enabled
two previous occasions
the
they've met both
really
in the NCAA tournament.
Back to serve will be Thayer.
Florida's won them both.
Hall finds
Greve with an awkward pass.
Vaught.
Now Greve will swing from the right.
For Greve in front of Merritt Beeson.
That's how you make up
for
making your setter work a little bit to find
seven
the right
and now
set Greve to make. She only really had one option right there with Greve right in front of her.
And
she sets it up perfectly.
And Florida has got to
there were Forte and
early
Victoria for Florida, but she went around
Greve
them for the kill.
Getting on a roll.
And here's Greve.
Serve for Greve. Overpass.
Serve over now
and it goes down for a kill.
Both players misjudged
on the pass.
Jazz. It went a little bit to the left of the Miami player.
That's called clean living, I guess.
Tontai. And that results in a point as it just falls.
Miami not seeing really the depth of that ball and it was heading
seven
over the net.
Well, and Tontai wasn't
in
able
honesty
to front
Marley
Monterey
has made some very athletic
as
plays.
Avalu was also trying to get a contact
through this
on
season
that
with
that
one or two hands with balls that seem to be doomed to be overpasses.
Vaught sets it up left side.
There's
nice
the big rip
from
the left pin for Janet.
Number 6.
Kalani Awalu.
Janet Kalani Awalu.
She had 10 kills last night. Had to work for him. 34 swings.
14
hit only 88.
by a half.
She is a high volume attacker.
Back to serve will be Priscilla.
One player
Hernandez.
Florida wants to defensively try to keep a lid
that
on.
That one sent long
that one just
and
misses.
Wide. Going to be another service
third
error.
Service
third
error for the Hurricanes
for
here in this opening
set.
That's one thing both teams are going to have to do is serve aggressively. You can live with
back
some errors.
One for the Gators
you just
as
can't,
goes back
for lack
serve.
Of a better term, lollipop it over and allow the other team to run their side-out offense in system.
Sometimes hitting at the left.
It's Marley Montserrat, one of
right.
five seniors
like
on the Gator squad, takes
right
a deep breath
time,
here and serves.
So Victoria can hit from the left.
Vox sets it up.
Great
nice
up from McKissick
from
the middle shot
from
layout. And Sophia Victoria terminates
for
Florida.
Sophia Victoria.
Four for four on the night is Sophia Victoria. And the Gators have doubled up Miami here in the opening set.
Lose possession of the
firing
ball.
On all cylinders to this point, Florida hitting well over 400
that they use with,
in this opening
with
frame.
Ball, or excuse me, Caesar and Beeson, where they'll stay for the first contact
Miami,
in this rotation.
Three
in
serve for C.
This rotation and hit opposite.
The outside hitter, Kalani Valu.
Montserrat able to get it into the
set to the right side, and Ardimchi will miss it. Florida. Second in the SEC, 20th in the NCAA in blocks per set. Miami, 14th in the NCAA in blocks per set. So a physical battle of the net in front of us tonight. Somehow Florida tried to get the ball over, but that goes for Miami. And if you're Mary Wise looking for number 1,001 win and moving into the Sweet 16, can't really envision a much better start than the one her Gators have delivered to this point as Vieira serves for Miami on the block cover for Hall. Block cover McKissick. Where will Vaught go? All the way to the outside. Block touch gives the back row defense for Florida a chance. Great diving play by Hernandez. Victoria up but misses. Marley Montserrat looking for maybe a touch, but asking her teammates, did you see one? There was not one. So the attack error for Victoria, her first of the night. Again, Vieira serving for the Hurricanes. Beeson blocked up on the block cover for Montserrat. And then the block issued by Kalani Avalu for Miami. You get the feeling that Florida in control, but Miami trying to make the run here to close the gap in the first set. That ball dug up and out of bounds. The kill for Sophia Victoria, who registers her first fifth kill in the opening set. Tops on the court. After the kill, Victoria serving. She with the wicked jump serve. Roll shot, Kalani Avalu. Florida with some two-hand pushes across the net, trying to catch Miami off guard, and the Gators get a free ball opportunity. Miami just had to send it across, and Thayer Hall terminates the unusual rally between the two teams. For her fifth kill in 10 swings. Continues her hot torrid hitting pace here on the weekend in first and second round action in her home gymnasium of Exact Tech Arena. Sophia Victoria, bad toss and caught the ball and lifted it up in the air. And a laugh from she and her teammates. When you're up by seven, it is the smile comes a little bit easier than when it's a little tighter, right? As Emily Damon serves it now for the Hurricanes. And she returns the favor with a service error. Lauren Forte checks back in for the Gators, and Ellie McKissick set to serve. As the 16 seed in the NCAA tournament, Florida with a 8-point lead here in the opening set against the team that many thought would get seeded in this tournament, the Miami Hurricanes. Third in their conference in the ACC. Tough league. Hall again. That's a senior play. Court vision tips it into Miami's front right. And Thayer Hall is 6-0-13 on her stat line. McKissick with the bullet, misses it long. So for the Gators, four service errors in the opening frame. Same number for Miami. On the scoreboard, Florida up 8. And Janice Leao serves for the Hurricanes. Tip shot, Beeson. Pancake save. Was that Rosado? No, it was Damon. Out to Thayer Hall. And Thayer Hall delivers again. Seventh kill in the opening set for Thayer Hall. Came into Florida. Incoming freshman class is the number one recruit in the entire country. 22-13 Florida. As Thayer Hall and Sophia Victoria, the Florida outsides have been outstanding. Grieve for Miami, the outside. The up from McKissick. Free ball sent across by Montserrat. Thayer Hall with the single block solo there. This has been the set of highlights for Thayer Hall. Worth another look as she goes up, tracking that slide play, going to tone tie all the way to that antenna, and she stuffs it with the block solo. Physical blocker on the left side for Florida is Thayer Hall. And a big smile from the senior of the Gators. Thayer Hall has had an unbelievable opening frame. As Thayer Hall gets in the action early from the outside. In the seam there between the two blockers. Off hands. Tip shot. You name it, and she's got it. And she's done it defensively as well with that block solo, forcing Jose Keno Gandara to take the second of his two timeouts here in the opening set as Thayer Hall, without an error on the night to this point, seven kills in the opening frame with just 14 attacks. And that big block solo just moments ago. Thayer Hall, a three-time AVCA All-American, first team All-SEC this year. 17 double-digit kill matches on the season. Seven double-doubles. She's in serve, receive, every rotation. For this season, it's been the libero, McKissick, and the two outsides for Florida. 99.9% of the time in serve, receive, so a heavy load for the senior Thayer Hall. As after the Miami called timeout, big lead for the Gators at 23-13. Double digit advantage as Beeson on the All-SEC freshman team serves it deep again. She had trouble with the float serve early in the year with a proclivity to serve errors. She went all the way back to the end of the floor, if you will, flat-footed from the ground and served, but now back to that jump float. Great save for Hernandez of Miami. Grieve down the line. Grieve earning her fourth kill, in the opening set. Serve Vock of Miami. One-handed set. Down to the floor, kill for Lauren Forte. It's set point Florida at 24-15. One for the highlight reel from Lauren Forte. The one-handed set, and Forte was in the air and available. First opportunity at set point here in the opening set is Thayer Hall. With the bullet. One-handed set of her own for Vock, but the Gators will have a chance here as Victoria will swing away, and it's out of bounds. The kill for Sophia Victoria, her sixth in the opening set. Combined that with Thayer Hall's seven, that's quite an opening frame for the Florida outside hitters as they hit the gas and win by 10 in the opening set, taking a one set to none lead over in-state rival Miami here in this NCAA Division I Women's Volleyball Championship second round match. Thayer Hall and the Gators celebrate the opening set win over Miami. Don't touch that dial. Don't log out. It's a tough decision to eat popcorn or dance. And this young man, well, he's got some moves. Must be in the jeans where he picked this up from. Just enjoying himself. And those dressed in orange and blue here certainly enjoying themselves after Florida hits 371 in the opening set and limits Miami to only 88. The two Florida outsides are the story to this point. Thayer Hall, 7 kills. Sophia Victoria, 6 kills. Only one error between the two of them in 22 attempts. And Thayer Hall also with 3 digs and 2 blocks, including that big block solo that really, near the end of the set, punctuated what Florida accomplished in the opening frame. But it's only 1 out of 3 the Gators would have to win to move to the Sweet 16. And this Miami team, who finished 3rd in the ACC, have been through the conference battles to get to this point and then beat South Alabama last night to get here into the second round. Tom Collette with you from Gainesville, Florida tonight, where Merritt Beeson will serve for Florida to open up the second set. Florida on the season, when winning the first set, are 19-3. Everyone goes silent as Beeson set to open up the frame for the Gators from the serve line. Right side, Grieve. Free ball across, Miami with an opportunity. Where will Vock go? To the right side to Grieve, who's over there. The tip shot played up by McKissick. And Victoria from the back row. 15 kills for Florida, 8 for Miami. And you look at that hitting percentage number and what the Florida outsides have done. Currently 667 for Victoria, 500 for Hall. And they have generated the Florida offense. From the left side, Gardimchi. Marley Montserrat gets into the act with the left hand. She has really worked hard on the second contact offense. She can swing with the left arm and the right. She can tip with both. Just the consummate pro, if you will, to coin a phrase, at setter here in her senior season, running the Florida offense in the 5-1. How about Thayer Hall up alongside of Forte again for another block? 3-0. Florida races out to the early lead here in the second set. Miami's first got to get a good first contact to be able to run the offense, and that's not one. The libero has to play it out to Yardimchi. Well-placed ball, though, so Florida will run it to the back row. And that is wide. It wasn't too far. It was just a little wide left as Victoria trying to find some open space. Miami on the board after the Florida error and sends Angela Grieve serving. Somehow Florida keeps it alive. The free ball sent across by Victoria for Florida. Yardimchi from the right side. Forte gets the bulk of that one. Hall up alongside to celebrate after the block. Closing late, Forte takes away the angle from Yardimchi, who thought she had an opening. Everyone again goes silent as Hall takes the deep breath on the serve. Shank pass, Kalia Novalu. Montserrat to the pipe. Just long for Hall. And the Gators celebrating. Mary Wise up off the Florida bench. Looking at the up official, Wade Brent, saying, was that out? So Thayer Hall with her first error on the night there. She thought she had one. As Priscilla Hernandez serves for Miami. Free ball sent across by Florida. In the middle. Layout played up by Hall. Yardimchi has to readjust. Back row right side, Merritt Beeson joins the hit parade with her 7th attack and her 1st kill. Back set, Beeson. Didn't go all the way to the antenna, setting up the block was Kalei Niawalu. Beeson took advantage of that going down the line. Trinity Adams serves and serves the ace. Trinity Adams with her 19th ace on the year.
Substitution for Hurricanes number 16, Nia Anderson.
As Nia Anderson will check in for Miami. See if the Gators target her and serve receive, and they do. Quick middle set. Janice Leao snaps one down. Payman Yardimchi, member of the All-ACC freshman team. Tough serve for McKissick to handle. Hall with the roll shot, though. Makes Mark Hernandez work for the up. And that one's in for Nia Anderson. True freshman from San Antonio, Texas. Ronald Reagan High School. Nia Anderson coming into action tonight. 104 sets for Miami on the year. Played in just 31. So Gandara looking for some different arm swings. And combinations it might work. Out to Anderson again. She's blocked, but a great block up from Hernandez. Montserrat, pipe attack, Hall, tip shot. Great up from Hernandez. Slide play, Bree Kelly. The up for Rosado. Anderson again, Gators block it back. Anderson again, go to the well again with the tip. Somehow Florida got it across. Right side, Leao. And it's out of bounds, but the kill for Leao as the Gator blockers directed it out of bounds. So Miami with that slide play to the right antenna for the junior, Janice Leao. Pull within one as Florida open up this frame with a 3-0 opening salvo. As here's Yardimchi. And the service ace ties the score. Yardimchi's first service ace of the weekend on the year, her 23rd. Florida runs Sophia Victoria, and she misses it. Gators looking for a touch. No call forthcoming. Miami takes the lead. Miami's first lead of the evening here at 7-6 in the second set. As Yardimchi already with an ace and another tough serve, bullets that one. Miami in a 5-0 run and make it 6-0 as another miss for Sophia Victoria. Mary Wise has seen enough after the Miami Hurricanes have roared back, trailing by three early, to take a lead of 8-6, riding a 6-0 scoring run to take this lead in the second set in this Division I Women's Volleyball Championship second round match in this battle of ranked teams here in Gainesville tonight. Miami forces a Florida timeout here in this second set. The Hurricanes on a 6-0 run to take this lead of 2 points at 8-6. Their first lead of the evening came just moments ago as Florida took the opening set 25-15. Sponsor will set the outside of Victoria. And this time, Sophia Victoria, after consecutive attack errors, will bury this one to get the Gators back to within one. Got to be a confidence booster. You come out of the timeout, and let's run a play for Sophia Victoria, who missed the last two after such a hot start. Montserrat serves for Florida. Pass for Rosado, right side. Leao, they found something at that right antenna on the slide play from Janice Leao. That's a tough play to defend. If you can run it efficiently, you've got to get a good first contact to give your setter an opportunity to set that up. And that's what exactly Miami's been doing better here in the second set. Better in serve receive as Damon serves for Miami. Quick set in the middle. Streaking down the middle to blast away is the freshman Beeson. Member of the SEC All-Freshman team. McKissick had to go down to get it. And the one-handed set from Monterey as she goes around layout. This Beeson. Victoria with another blast of a topspin jump serve. Blocked back by Beeson. The tip attempted there by Angela Grieve. But Beeson hung in the air and sent it back down with two hands. And celebrates with former member of the SEC All-Freshman team there, Bree Kelly. Tied at nine, Victoria. Hernandez with the pass. Great hustle to get that, diving McKissick. Victoria back row delivers, and Florida retakes the lead. McKissick just right at the attack line with a diving play. And only one up for Miami there, as you saw Leal trying to make a block on the Florida pipe attacker from the back row there, Sophia Victoria. Sixth service error on the night for Florida. And we're tied at 10. First team to win three sets, best three out of five, as the Gators up one set to none. Here hosting second round action in Gainesville. Bree Kelly. For a brief moment at least, Florida back in the lead, 11-10. Florida all time in NCAA second round matches, 23-5. All the meetings during the Mary Wise tenure. Last year, of course, in the bubble, defeated Morehead State. Three sets to none. Tough serve to handle. Lauren Forte was watching Tone tie the whole time, timed it perfectly, and collects the block solo. Miami had trouble in serve receive, and Forte kept a watchful eye on it all and perfectly timed for the block solo. Out to Grieve. The up from Victoria. One-handed set. To Forte goes Monterey. And that connection, good again. Lauren Forte with the outsides getting so much activity in the opening set. Just two kills on her second look there. And Florida with a three-point lead. Miami will go again to Grieve on the outside. Heavy dose of Angela Grieve. Hall with the tip. Played up by Yarjimchi. Angela Grieve. Angela Grieve coming into the NCAA tournament. Sixth in the Atlantic Coast Conference at 3.77 kills per set. All ACC second team selection. And again, the connection to that middle blocker, Lauren Forte, is dynamite for Florida. That is just so lightning fast as a blocker. You've got to be really anticipating that quickly to get up there and try to stop Lauren Forte. Miami responds with a set to the middle. Ferrari Stay, Arstia, Tone Tie. For Tone Tie, she's on the board now with her first kill in three swings. Serve Grieve for Miami. How about the defense from Miami here? As Nia Anderson off the bench has been an uplifting factor for this Miami Hurricane team here in the second frame. Monterey wins the joust with Anderson. Back to Anderson goes the Hurricanes. Behind the block, nice play by Tone Tie. Yarjimchi dug up by McKissick. And from the back row, yet again, Sophia Victoria. Thayer Hall set to serve for the Gators. Already on the night, 7 kills for the senior, 5 digs and 4 blocks. I thought someone was in the net, might have been the ball, as Tone Tie is played up by the Gators. Right side, Dardimchi. Beeson with the up for Florida. Right side, Yardimchi with the tip. McKissick couldn't get there behind the block. Nicely placed ball by Payman Yardimchi. Who had 13 kills last night against South Alabama. The lefty has a lot of shot selections there and picked the tip and caught the sideline. Right in front of the diving McKissick in the orange libero jersey for Florida. Victoria on the outside. A touch called. So the kill for Sophia Victoria now make it 11. Looks like off the side of the head of the libero, Priscilla Hernandez, who it takes a lot of courage to be there on the left back position when you've got a hitter like Victoria. And also Thayer Hall for Florida from that left antenna taking those angle shots right at you. And Jose Keno Gandara, will he take a challenge here? Or will the discussion just continue? Darren Clark, the down official, in discussion with the Miami head coach. I guess he's not going to use a challenge here. Florida with a 2-point lead, and Trinity Adams checks in to serve. Out to Victoria again. Ouch. Rosado took that one off, I believe, the left shoulder. That was on her in a hurry in back middle. I talked about the angle shot going into back left, but ouch. Right off the left shoulder of Yadeliz Rosado. And Sophia Victoria, dare I say, is en fuego. 12 kills on the night, topping everyone on the floor. Thayer Hall next with 7 for Florida. Worth taking another look at some of the activity tonight for Sophia Victoria, the 6'1 sophomore from Garabo, Puerto Rico. As she plays it off hands, down the line, tooling the block. Hitting one in the back left against the libero, and in the seam there between the libero and the back middle player. Back row attack as well for Sophia Victoria, who really shined in the middle of this Gators season. Had a career high 24 kills at Florida State in her first career start. 5 consecutive 10 or more kill matches. FSU, 2 against Coastal Carolina, and 2 against Mississippi State. And now in the absence of Tiara Caesar, she is asked once again and thrust into the starting role for this Florida team in the postseason. And she has responded. Team high 13 kills last night. She's almost there tonight, and we're not through with set number 2. The 2 Florida outsides have 19 of Florida's 27 kills. Hall next at 7 on the chart. 15 kills on the other side for Miami. Total. Amongst the entire team. Serve for Trinity Adams. Monterey will go to back right to Beeson. Just a tip, played up by Hernandez. That's a good look in the middle for Janice Leao. Miami, one of 6 teams from the ACC in the tournament field. As Yardimchi serves for the Hurricanes. Thayer Hall from the back row just unloads. Lock and load and let her rip. 8th kill of the night for Thayer Hall. Just goes around the middle blocker there, Janice Leao to her right. And she is one of the most intense players on the court for Florida. And not really playing at 100%. all year. Preseason, injured one of the hips. She's really had a great end to the senior season, though, with the way she played down the stretch. Montserrat goes outside to Victoria. And this time, Sophia Victoria misfires, trying a severe cut. So Miami with changes. And check again. Serving it here will be Emily Damon. Out to Victoria. And Sophia Victoria's attack is long. Miami within one. Miami will go to the outside. Here's Grieve. Vock with the block cover. Free ball sent across by Layout. Montserrat sets it across. Hernandez wasn't caught napping. Back set, right side. Beeson off hands. Merritt Beeson delivers her third kill of the night. Merritt Beeson with 11 attacks, but she's been smart. When the really good look isn't there, she's tipped it, kept it in play. Allowed the Gators to play defense. No errors yet for Merritt. Three kills on the night. And here's Victoria with the blast into the net. Florida's seventh service error on the evening. Back to within one of the Hurricanes. And Janice Leal serving. That means on the other side of the rotation, Aristea Tontai back in the middle blocker spot on the other side for Miami in the front row. Hall off the net with the roll. And it's just out. So Thayer Hall gets her ninth kill on the evening. As Florida will serve Ellie McKissick here. Forte back on the court for the Gators. And she makes her presence known after being on the bench for three rotations and gets the block. Three-point lead late here for Florida. Both teams each have a timeout remaining. I would imagine if Florida can score a point here that we'll see Jose Keno Gandara take a timeout for Miami. Out to Grieve go the Hurricanes. Great save from McKissick. Free ball sent across by Beeson. Miami with a chance. But the up from McKissick keeps it alive. And Thayer Hall, she's in double digits with that roll shot kill. Florida up by four late at 22-18. I mentioned Miami head coach Jose Keno Gandara does have a timeout left, as does Mary Wise. Grieve is blocked. Great block up though from Miami. And there's Hernandez again with the up. One more time. That one's stuffed again. Now Miami will take the timeout. What an incredible defensive effort there from Florida. As the serve from McKissick starts the trend to the outside. Grieve actually had the first block cover, then Hernandez. Let's try this again. Forte up with Beeson for all three of those plays against Angela Grieve on the left side. Angela Grieve, one of their high volume hitters, has the most attacks on the night. She went from 23 to 26 on one rally with those three consecutive attacks. And the Gators exhibiting the defense that has them second in the SEC with 2.6 blocks per set, 20th in the NCAA. As I mentioned previously, to continue that thought, the Miami Hurricanes out of the ACC, been through the ACC wars. Louisville, Pitt, UNC, FSU, Georgia Tech, and the Hurricanes, as we look at the upper left side of your bracket if you're following along at home. Ball State beat Michigan earlier today. Louisville and UIC will be who Ball State gets in the next round. Those matches in Louisville. Here in Gainesville, of course, action yesterday as Miami came back from trailing 0-1 to beat South Alabama, and the Gators sweep Florida A&M for the 12th time in the series, the rivalry between the two Florida schools. Gators with a big lead late coming out of the Miami timeout. They will go to the slide play, and Tone Tie misses it wide. So the Gators are at set point here in the second, 24-18 after the attack error on that slide play by the graduate student from Athens, Greece, Aristea Tone Tie. Gator fans here in the Exact Tech Arena on their feet. They always scream yes and no. Yes for the Florida contacts, no for the Miami or opponent contacts. Beeson with a big rip, but how about the up from Vieira? There's that blocking combination again for Florida's. Go back to Grieve again. This time, Grieve gets one through Beeson and Forte to extend the set another point. For Miami, they've got to score now five more consecutive points to force this one past 25. Tall order, and they'll have Savannah Vox serving here. She had two service aces last night against South Alabama and one error. Forte couldn't get up on top of that one and sailed it long. Those here in Exact Tech Arena remain on their feet in anticipation of Florida going up two sets to none. Solid pass from Victoria. And Beeson with the kill. Her fourth kill of the match ends the second set on Florida's third opportunity at set point. The Gators go up two sets to none in this Sunshine State showdown for a trip to the Sweet 16 on the line. The Gators lead it two sets to none after taking the second, 25-20. Thayer Hall celebrates, as does Lauren Forte. The Gators up 2-0. The 16 seed Florida Gators have dominated play to this point in this match, and it's reflected in the numbers. Close to 300, limiting Miami to only a 63 hitting efficiency mark. Seven blocks for Florida through two sets. And when they haven't terminated rallies with blocks, they have touched balls and given the back row defense an opportunity to make plays in rallies, allowing Marley Montserrat in transition to run the Florida offense. Miami's got to win this one or their season is done here as we open up play in the third set. Tom Collette with you as Lauren Forte gets the quick look in the middle and gets her fourth kill on the night. Florida breaks out on top here in the third set, 1-0. Merritt Beeson ready to serve for Florida. Beeson's been a very smart hitter tonight. And her serve has been on par. Right side Grieve. Victoria with the up. Again, Florida will go to Hall. takes a couple steps towards the middle of the court. A little different set, a little farther in from Marley Montserrat. Good look and a kill for Thayer Hall. Give her 11 on the night. Her fellow outside, Sophia Victoria with 12. 23 of Florida's 34 kills from the outsides. And that's in for a service ace. Merritt Beeson with her 14th ace on the year. For the Gators on the night, third in the scorebook. Going to serve it at Anderson again. Right side, Grieve. The lefty, Ardimchi. In this rotation, she's on the left and Grieve is on the right. And she registers the kill to get Miami on the scoreboard. Ardimchi is one of the hitters that Florida has frustrated to this point. She's two kills only in 12 swings with three errors. As Grieve serves it to get us back in play. Thayer Hall with a dozen herself. Florida's two outsides, each with 12 on the evening. Thayer Hall, the senior, playing her last match on the home floor with four other seniors for Florida. As Ardimchi again misses. And if you're Jose Keno Gendar of Miami, how long do you wait to take a timeout? He waited last set. Miami roared back after being down 3-0, but then Florida streaked to the finish. Tough play. I thought an over-the-net violation might have been called there. Montserrat steps in with a left hand and sends it down. For a moment there, I thought that the whistle would be blown as Forte went up and tapped it back. Thought it might have been over the net. But Montserrat terminates. Florida 6, Miami 1. Grieve is blocked by Forte. What a start to the third set for Florida. Gators now on a 4-0 scoring run to take a 6-point lead. And Jose Keno Gendara, head coach for Miami, takes the timeout here. The Gators, to open up the third, are on fire, leading by 6, trying for back-to-back sweeps here in the first and second rounds in Gainesville on their home court. Number 16 seed in this Division I Women's Volleyball Championship, Florida, a commanding 2-0 lead in sets. And here in the third, they have opened 4-0-5 on the attack line. 800 to open up the set and opening up with a 6-point lead at 7-1, forcing the Miami timeout. And the serve from Thayer Hall is an ace. That was on top of Yadeliz Rosado in a hurry. What a match Hall has had. And back-to-back aces. Thayer Hall with 12 kills, 7 digs, 4 blocks, 2 aces, and an assist. She's done it in every aspect of the game tonight, and she'll serve it again here. 5th, 6th serve make it this turn in the rotation. And the corresponding 20 on the other side, Ari Stea Tontai for Miami, ends the Florida scoring run. But Miami in a big hole here. They've got to be able to run some points now while serving, which they've not exhibited to this point. Gator serve receive has been solid on the evening. And that's not going to make your head coach very happy. After you finally break a scoring run, you serve one out. But that's indeed what happened. As for Florida, Trinity Adams checks back in. Forte to the bench, and Bree Kelly back in the match in the front row for the Gators at middle blocker. That's probably the best pass set kill in the side out offense all night for Miami as they go quickly in the middle to Janice Leao. Great setter, hitter connection. As Florida had two blockers up. Ardimchi with the serve for Miami. in a big hole. Out to Anderson. Hall with the dig that goes across the net. Getting the middle involved, Janice Leao. Again, slide play, taking off like a layup in basketball, off 1 foot towards that right antenna, sending that middle blocker out there. An effective attack weapon as Yardimchi serves again. Tough pass from Victoria. Up for Hernandez for Miami. Leao. Right side, Beeson for Florida. That ate up Yardimchi. Merrick Beeson delivers her fifth kill of the evening. Again, yet with a blemish on her attack line. 5-0-14. When the optimum look hasn't been there, she's taken the smart swing. Marley Monterey serves for Florida. How about the block for Bree Kelly in the middle? Ninth block of the night for Florida. And all smiles on the Florida bench and as well as the players on the court. Up 2-0 and up by 8 here in the third set. Hall from the back row, the up for Hernandez. Anderson, Miami. Off Beeson for the kill. Again, this is a point where Miami, as Anderson goes out, and Emily Damon checks in to serve in that spot. Miami's got to be able to run points while serving to get back in this set and match, which Florida serve receive has been pretty solid tonight. Right side, Grieve, it's long, and there's a touch at the net. So the kill for Angela Grieve, make it 7 on the evening. She's taken 32 swings to get there. High volume hitter, Angela Grieve. Down the middle, Beeson, the up from Bach. And that is called illegal contact double hit. Some of the fans behind me wanted a few earlier in a couple previous rallies where Vlock would steer one to a specific location and kind of came out awkwardly, but I like the way this match is being officiated tonight. As Florida now with a 7-point lead here in the third and Victoria serving. Tip shot, Grieve. Kelly, part of the block, plays it up. Thayer Hall, only her second miss of the night. So Miami will send Leao to serve. So Tone Tie back on the court in the front row for the Hurricanes. That was a bullet that Thayer Hall played well. Tone Tie with the up. Excuse me, Leao. Tone Tie's in the front row. I beg your pardon. But how about that laser beam? Merritt Beeson. What an efficient night for the freshman. 6-0-16. Her stat line. And then celebrates with the setter who gave her the delivery. Slide play, Tone Tie. And she got it in. Savannah Bach, setter for Miami, will serve it here. Bach had 2 service aces last night and an error in the match against South Alabama. And Merritt Beeson from the right side delivers a blast. And now Merritt Beeson to serve as everyone in Exact Tech goes silent. Dig for Beeson. Out to Hall. cake, saved by Vock. And it's long. Miami players looking for a touch. And we have a challenge from Jose Keno Gandara. As the Miami players, very animated on their side, saying there was a touch on that attack. As Darren Clark will check in with our replay crew on the far side. Jeff Cardozo, the public address announcer, just announced it to the crowd that that was, in fact, a challenge. And maybe Thayer Hall checked the ball rotation. Comes out. It's spinning off to the down left a little bit. I didn't really see a change in rotation there. That's one indication. And the line judge, as we zoom in on it, oh boy. Gotta be indisputable video evidence. I can't really tell from those shots if there was a touch or not. Mary Wise, winner of her 1,000th career match last night in the 3-0 sweep over Florida A&M. As Jose Keno Gandara is just going to take a seat and let the replay officials do their job, I guess, here. Letting one of his assistants talk to the team, and now a players only meeting for Miami on the side, and there's another look at it. A little different angle. I didn't really see Thayer Hall's fingers move at all on that right hand. Spending an extended period of time on this one is our replay official. Want to get it right. Florida, if it stands as a ball hit out on an error, 16-8. Reversal would make it 15-9, of course. Miami still with a long road ahead in this third set, down 0-2. Take a look around the bracket while we have a moment. Louisville up 2-0 over UIC. Pitt up 2-0 over University of Maryland, Baltimore County. Penn State awaits to play them in the next round. For Louisville, it'll be Ball State if they can advance. Kansas at Creighton just getting underway. And it stays with Florida. No touch. Utah defeats Utah Valley in four. Georgia Tech up 2-0 over Citadel. Kentucky takes the first set from Southeast Missouri State. We'll check some more scores as we get into it here. 16-8 Gators. Beeson to serve again. Right side, Grieve, and it's out.
The attack was wide, point Florida.
Miami trying to contend with a big Gator block. And it's frustrated the Hurricanes. On the match, only hitting 61. As Beeson misses that one.
Service error, point Miami.
For the Gators, eighth service error on the evening. More than Miami, but not really, that's the word I'm looking for, bothersome in terms of serving aggressively as Miami returns the favor with the service error. Florida has doubled up the Hurricanes here in the third set. Now the fans just in anticipation for Florida to get the win and move on to the Sweet 16. And move to 26-3 all time in second round matches here in the Big Dance. Back row, Beeson. Anderson misses. Double digit lead for Florida here in the third set. And the Gators have it in cruise control on their home court. Up 2-0 and looking for back-to-back sweeps against in-state opponents and trying to move on to the Sweet 16. And earned Mary Wise the 1,001st victory in her 35-year collegiate coaching. Tom Collette with you as the Gator Band strikes up the Paul Simon tune, You Can Call Me Al. It's been a block party for the Gators tonight, as you see some of the gentlemen in overalls with block party on the front. Gators with 9 blocks in this match to this point, above their season average of 2.6 blocks per set. And they set the tone early, did the Gators. And offensively, as of late, the freshman Barrett Beeson, who's had a very efficient night, takes the one-hand set for Monterey, attacks from the right side. They didn't take the line away. And then moves towards the middle of the court, floating to her left. Angle shot from the right, and a big smile from Barrett Beeson, one of the two Florida members on the SEC all-freshman team, along with Bree Kelly, who took over the starting role, did Bree Kelly from Lauren Dooley, and has started the last 11 matches. But Merritt Beeson has played on the left. She's played on the right, mostly on the right, especially as of late. And last night, she had a career-high 3 service aces against Florida A&M, did Beeson. Hall's serve is in play here. Out to Anderson. Beeson with the up. Victoria is blocked. First Miami block I've called in a long time, just their second on the night. For the Hurricanes, here's Priscilla Hernandez. Out to Victoria. Cover from Marley Monterey for Florida on the block. Block goes to the outside to Anderson. Victoria, net shaking a lot. Up from Vock for Miami. Up from McKissick of Florida. Vock will go to the middle and pushed across by Janice Leao. I think Mary Wise was thinking maybe that's a little too much contact with the ball on that push. With just a smile to the down official, Darren Clark. And during that long rally, Gators sprawling on the floor at various times. It's a little janitorial work on the floor. Get the towel crew out. Here's Hernandez. Out to Victoria goes Florida. And Sophia Victoria, 13th kill on the night. Trinity Adams in, Bree Kelly in for Florida as McKissick and Forte to the Florida bench. McKissick just for the moment, as Bree Kelly will play the next 3 rotations in the front row in the middle blocker spot for the Gators. Bullet serve passed by Anderson. She'll take the assist attempt, take the set and hit it into the net. Gators with a double-digit lead. Florida set the tone early here in this match and has been dominant against their in-state rival Miami here in the second round match. Looking for back-to-back sweeps against 2 opponents from the state, Florida A&M and now the Hurricanes. Hurricanes go to Leao in the middle, and she delivers with her 10th kill of the night. She's been one of the bright spots for this Miami Hurricane squad. 10 kills, only 2 errors and 22 swings. When they've been able to get the ball to Leao, she has delivered. Here's Yardimchi serving for the Hurricanes. Out to Victoria. Pancake save. Who was that? Was that Rosado? Yes. But look out! Bree Kelly. Mentioned her as a member of the SEC All-Freshman team. Worth another look here. As the set out to Anderson. Bree Kelly says, no, you're not going to have that angle shot here with me closing the block. Marley Monterey. The error. Miami with changes. Checking in to serve is Emily Damon. Oh. Here's the Damon serve. Marley sets it across. How about the pancake save from Damon? The up from McKissick of Grieve. Marley Montre with the up of Leao. Bach goes outside to Grieve. And Grieve off the block attempt of Beeson. And Kelly will score the point for the Hurricanes. Grieve has taken 38 swings, most of anyone on the court. 8 kills to show for it. And 8 errors on the evening. The 7th service error of the night for Miami as the Gators creep closer to a berth into the Sweet 16 in this year's Big Dance. Victoria, the sophomore, to serve here. Vox sets the outside to Grieve. The up from McKissick, 23rd of the night. Make it 24. Miami will keep it alive and send it across the free ball. Where will Marley Montserrat go? To Kelly, right in front of her. Great up there from Damon. Bree Kelly throws a green strap off the court. And play stopped. Ask for a replay. That flew off, and she tried to get it out of the way, knowing Florida might have had an opportunity. So we'll get the replay here. That was interesting, to say the least. In all the years of doing volleyball, I haven't seen that before. So Sophia Victoria will serve it here. The short ball, ooh, it just caught the net. Layout to serve here for the Hurricanes, as Tone Tai back in the front row for the Hurricanes. Out to Hall. Beeson is blocked. Grieve is out there along with Tone Tai. Again, Leao to serve. To Bree Kelly, fans to their feet. It's match point, Florida. Gators 1 point away from advancing into the Sweet 16. McKissick to serve. Forte back on the court. Fans on their feet. Grieve with the swing. McKissick with yet another up. Thayer Hall got it in. The perfect way to end her senior season here on her home court, sending the Gators into the Sweet 16. Thayer Hall's 13th kill on the night, matching Sophia Victoria atop the Gators hit parade, tying her for match high as the Gators outsides get 26 kills on the night out of the 42 for Florida. And they beat an in-state rival in sweep fashion for the 2nd straight night and move on to play in an NCAA regional semifinal next weekend as Mary Wise celebrates with her Florida Gators. The Florida Gators move on in the NCAA tournament with a 3-0 sweep over Miami after sweeping Florida A&M last night. Florida Gators in this 2nd round match get the sweep over in-state rival Miami and have advanced to the Sweet 16 in this 2021 Division I Women's Volleyball Championship as they celebrate for the home fans the last time here this season, led by one of the seniors, Marley Montserrat. That'll do it for our coverage tonight here. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. Tom Collette saying so long from Gainesville as the Gators move on.